Dear students, Sat Shri Akal. In today's video, we are presenting a video of class 8, subject computer science. In this video, we have revised lesson 1 to lesson 8 by answering all the questions according to the syllabus. So let's get started. So we will now learn about multiple choice question in lesson number 1. And our first question is, Bash font can be used to type in Punjabi? And their options are Anmol Lipi, Ravi, Joy, and the last one is all of the above. And the right answer is all of the above font can be used to type in Punjabi. And second one is, what is the full form of Unicode? And their options are Union Code, Unified Code, Universal Code, and the last one is none of these. And the right answer is the full form of Unicode is Universal Code. And the third one is, which of the following Unicode font can be used for typing in Punjabi? And their options are Anmol Lipi, Ravi, Asis, and the last one is all of these. And the right answer is Ravi Unicode font can be used for typing in Punjabi. And fourth one is, which of the following phonetic font can be used for typing in Punjabi? And their options are Anmol Lipi, Ravi, Asis, and the last one is all of these. And the right answer is Anmol Lipi phonetic font can be used for typing in Punjabi. And the fifth one is, to use number pad, dash should be kept on. And the options are num lock, caps lock, scroll lock, and the last one is none of these. And the right answer is, to use number pad, num lock key should be kept on. So now we will learn about write true or false in lesson number 1. And the first one is, for typing, the keyboard is divided in two parts, one for the left hand and one for the right hand. True. Second one is, touch typing is a technique by which we can learn typing with all fingers while looking at keyboard. False. Third one is, Anmol Lipi font helps us typing in Punjabi. True. Fourth one is, we use our little finger for the space bar. False. Fifth one is, shift key is used to move down to a new line. False. So now we will learn about short answer type questions in lesson number 1. The first question is, what is touch typing? And their answer is, touch typing is a technique by which we can learn typing with all fingers step by step without having to look down at the keyboard. If all the time we keep on looking for right keys on keyboard, then it slow down our typing speed a lot. And the second question is, what are the different types of font used for typing in Punjabi? And the answer is, there are many different type of font available for typing in Punjabi. The font commonly used for Punjabi typing can be divided into two main types. The first one is phonetic font, and its examples are Anmol Lipi font, and second one is Unicode font, and its example is Ravi font. And the third question is, how to type in Punjabi language? And the answer is, before start typing in Punjabi, we need to choose the appropriate font for typing in a Punjabi. There are many fonts which are available for typing in Punjabi. For example, Anmol Lipi, Ravi, Asis, Joy, etc. Anmol Lipi font is a phonetic font which is one of the easiest font to learn typing in Punjabi. For typing with Unicode font, Ravi font is commonly used for typing in Punjabi. And the fourth question is, name any three font to type in Punjabi language. And the answer is, there are many font for typing in Punjabi language. Some of these are given below. The first one is Anmol Lipi, second one is Ravi, third one is Asis, and fourth one is Joy. So now we will learn about long answer type question in lesson number 1. So the first question is, how can we improve typing speed? And their answer is, following are some suggestions which helps us to improve typing speed. And the first one is, our hand or finger position should always be in home position. We should reach for other keys from home position. And second one is, we should focus on accuracy, not on speed. Speed will come with time and practice. And third one is, don't look at the keyboard while typing. And the fourth one is, be steady, even pace, and strive for accuracy. And the fifth one is, as we tap each key, we should say its letter to ourselves. And the second question is, what are the important things to keep in mind while typing, or explain the proper posture while typing? And the answer is, during typing, the following thing should be kept in mind regarding proper posture. The first one is, we should sit up straight while typing. Second one is, our focus should be on the monitor or the copy. And third one is, the monitor should be at our eye level. And fourth one is, we should sit up straight in front of the keyboard and monitor. And the fifth one is, after pressing the keys, our finger should be returned on the home row. And the sixth one is, our feet should be flat on the floor. So now we will learn about multiple choice question in lesson number 2, that is internet fundamental. So the first question is, international network of computer is known as dash, and the options are ARPANET, intranet, internet, and the last one is Ethernet. And the right answer is, international network of computer is known as internet. And second one is, www stand for dash, and the options are World Wide Web, World Web Wide, Wide World Web, and the last one is Web World Wide. And the right answer is www stand for World Wide Web. And the third one is, a dash is an online conversation over the internet, and the options are e-commerce, chatting, www, or none of these. And the right answer is, a chatting is an online conversation over the internet. And the fourth one is, dash is the fastest way of sending mails. And the options are telegram, letters, ISP, and the last one is email. And the right answer is, email is the fastest way of sending mails. And the fifth one is, dash is a device that connects a computer with telephone line. And the options are modem, telephone wire, mouse, and the last one is mobile. And the right answer is, modem is a device that connects a computer with telephone line. So now we will learn about write the full form of the following terms. And the first one is www, which stands for World Wide Web. And second one is email. Email stands for electronic mail. Third one is modem. Modem stands for modulator, demodulator. Fourth one is ISP. ISP stands for internet service provider. And the fifth one is URL. URL stands for uniform resource locator. Sixth one is DSL. DSL stands for digital subscriber line. So now we will learn about short answer type question in lesson number 2. So the first question is, what is internet? And the answer is, internet stands for international network of computer. The internet is a network of network that consists of millions of computers spread across the world. Internet is one of the best technology gifted to mankind in the present scenario. And the second question is, give some example of internet service providers. And their answer is, internet service provider ISP refers to a company that provides internet services. Following are the common example of ISP. And the first one is Airtel, second one is Vodafone, and third one is BSNL, etc. And the third question is, what do you mean by the term e-commerce? And the answer is, e-commerce stands for electronic commerce. E-commerce is one of the most important services provided by the internet. We can purchase almost everything at any time from home using e-commerce websites. And the fourth question is, what is web browsing? And the answer is, moving from page to page or website to website in search of information is known as web browsing. To browse or search the information, we can take the help of any search engine such as Google, Bing, etc. So now we will learn about long answer type question. So the first question is, what is modem? Also explain its type and speed. And the answer is, modem stands for modulator, demodulator. This device is used for connecting over the internet. It enables a computer to transmit data over telephone line or cable lines. So type of modem. So modem are of two types. The first one is external modem. It is a separate device which is connected with computer using cables. Its speed is more than the speed of internal modem. And the second one is internal modem. It is fitted inside the system unit. It is slower in speed as compared to external modem. And the second question is, explain the facilities provided by the internet. And the answer is, following are Following are the common facilities provided by the internet. The first one is, the internet provides us the facility to read news from various online newspapers. Second one is, internet is a major source of art and entertainment. And third one is, we can purchase many types of goods from home with the help of internet. And fourth one is, we can send and receive messages to anyone at any time with the help of internet. And the fifth one is, we can book railway or air ticket from home with the help of internet. And the sixth one is, we can do chatting with the help of internet. And seventh one is, internet provides us the facility of video conferencing. And the third question is, what is email? Write the advantages of using email. And their answer is, email stands for electronic mail. It is one of the most important services provided by the internet. We can send or receive messages to or from anyone at any time using email. We can send or receive text, pictures, or any type of files using emails. And the advantages of email are, so following are the main advantages of using email. The first one is cost. So cost given for use of internet is the only money given for using email. Second one is speed. Email messages can reach at their destination within no time. Third one is convenience. We can send email messages at any time according to our convenience. The fourth question is, write a note on World Wide Web. And the answer is, World Wide Web is also known as Web or W3. It is a collection of huge information. It includes all the public websites which are connected with the internet throughout the world. Each website or page is given a unique name or address, which is known as URL. And URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. We can access the information stored on the World Wide Web with the help of web browser, such as Internet Explorer, Mozilla Firefox, etc. And the fifth question is, what are the main services provided by internet? Explain briefly. And the answer is, in today's technological world, there are plenty of services that are provided by the internet. Following are some of the important services provided by the internet. The first one is email. We can send or receive messages worldwide using this service. Second one is chatting. It is an online conversation over the internet using text messages. And third one is e-commerce. Doing business electronically with the help of internet is called e-commerce. And the fourth one is searching. We can search any type of information on the internet. Fifth one is surfing. The process of using website over internet is known as surfing. Sixth one is video conferencing. It involves face-to-face conversation using video cameras connected to computers. And seventh one is file downloading. We can download different type of files using internet. So now we will learn about multiple choice question in lesson number 3. The first question is, dash means our computer is receiving data from the internet. And the options are uploading, downloading, surfing, and the last one is none of these. And the right answer is, downloading means our computer is receiving data from the internet. And the second one is, the opening page of a website is usually called dash. And the options are home page, web page, main page, and the last one is none of these. And the right answer is, the opening page of a website is usually called home page. And third one is, dash indicate a state of connectivity. And the options are offline, online, inline, and the last one is none of these. And the right answer is, online indicate a state of connectivity. And the fourth one is, dash means to move from place to place, one website to another website on the internet to search for the topic of interest. And their options are web searching, downloading, web surfing, and the last one is all of these. And the right answer is, web surfing means to move from place to place on the internet to search for the topic of interest. And the fifth one is, dash is a form of electronic commerce which allows consumer to directly buy goods or services from a seller over the internet using a web browser. And their options are net banking, email, online shopping, and the last one is mobile. And the right answer is online shopping is a form of electronic commerce which allows consumer to directly buy goods or services from a seller over the internet using a web browser. So now we will learn about right, true or false. So the first one is the result of any board or university can be seen online, true. Second one is offline means we are connected with the internet, false. Third one is a website has only a single web page, false. Fourth one is web search is the act of looking for web pages, true. Fifth one is each website has its own unique website address, true. So now we will learn about fill in the blank in lesson number 3. So the first one is a collection of one or more pages grouped under the same domain is called website. And the second one is dash means not connected with internet. And the answer is offline means not connected with internet. And the third one is dash technology is providing us new tools of communication to collect knowledge and information. And the right answer is information technology is providing us new tools of communication to collect knowledge and information. And fourth one is bank that provide the facility of net banking are also known as dash. And the right answer is bank that provide the facility of net banking are also known as virtual bank. And the fifth one is we can buy goods from home using dash. And the right answer is we can buy goods from home using online shopping. So now we will learn about short answer type questions. So the first question is what is information technology? And the answer is information technology is also known as IT. It is a technology that related with computer hardware and software. It is used to process, store and transfer information. Information technology play a big and important role in the progress of any country. It is changing the way of our lifestyle, learning, playing and working. And the second question is what is website? And the answer is a website is a collection of one or more web pages grouped under the same domain. Pages of website are linked together with the help of hyperlinks. Each web page has a unique address which is known as Uniform Resource Locator. The very first page of a website is called its homepage. To view the content of website or pages, we have to use web browsers. And the third one is what is searching? And the answer is searching means finding something. So searching on internet is performed when we do not know the URL of web pages that have information to be searched. The search engine are used to search the information on the World Wide Web. Google and Bing are the most popular search engines. And the fourth question is, what do you mean by online and offline? And the answer is, online and offline are the technical term used in the world of internet. So following description explain these terms. So as you see in the below table, on the left side online and on the right side offline terms are given. So the first point is online means we are connected with internet, whereas offline means we are not connected with the internet. And the second one is when we are online, we are working with the files that are stored on the web server, whereas when we are offline, we are working with the files that are stored on our device or computer or mobile. So now we will learn about long answer type question in lesson number 3. The first question is explain the need of information technology. And the answer is following uses in different areas shows the need of information technology. And the first one is IT in business and industry. So information technology is required in business and industry to make the processing of work easier. Second one is IT in homes. So information technology is required in home for the purpose of education, communication and entertainment. And the third one is IT in training. So information technology is required for the training purpose in the field of schools, colleges and in many other areas. And the second question is write the steps to view online result. And the answer is following process can be followed to view the online result. And the first one is, first of all, open any web browser. And the second point is, now type the URL of website having a result. And third one is, select the session and class detail for which we want to view the result. And the fourth one is, fill the details that are required to view the result, such as roll number, name of student, etc. And the fifth point is, now click on the search result link or button. And third question is, write a note on mobile technology. And the answer is, mobile technology is a portable technology. This technology is a part of information technology. Mobile technology makes it possible to communicate with the places of the world that are very far from us. It has completely changed the face of communication. So following are some important uses of mobile technology. And the first one is education. Second one is surveys and polling. Third one is banking. And fourth one is data analysis. And the fourth question is, explain about online shopping. And the answer is, online shopping is a form of doing electronic commerce. It allows us to purchase goods and services from home using the internet. We can do online shopping at any time from any corner of the world. The bill payment of online shopping can be paid with the help of credit or debit card or net banking, etc. The purchased item will be delivered to our home by the merchant. Amazon, Flipkart, etc. are the popular e-commerce sites for online shopping. And the fifth question is, what is net banking? Explain. And the answer is, net banking is also known as online banking. Net banking has completely changed the way of working of bank. We can do many banking activities from home with the help of internet. Following are some of the common activities that we can do from home using net banking. The first one is, we can get detail of our bank account. Second one is, we can do bill payment of electricity, etc. Third one is, we can transfer fund to other account from our own account. And fourth one is, bank that provide the facility of net banking are also known as virtual bank, cyber bank or web bank. So now we will learn about multiple choice question in lesson number 4, that is introduction to PowerPoint. The first question is, Dash is a presentation graphic software, and the options are PowerPoint, Word, Excel, and the last one is Paint. And the right answer is, PowerPoint is a presentation graphic software. And second one is, a Dash is the process of presenting a topic to an audience. And the options are word processor, slide, presentation, transition. And the right answer is, a presentation is the process of presenting a topic to an audience. And third one is, a Dash is a single page of presentation. And the options are slide, document, sheet. And the last one is none of these. And the right answer is, a slide is a single page of presentation. And the fourth one is, Dash contains the current slide in our presentation. And the options are outline pane, content pane, ribbon, and the last one is slide pane. And the right answer is, slide pane contains the current slide in our presentation. So now we will learn about very short answer type question. So the first one is, how to open PowerPoint? And the answer is, start, then all program, then Microsoft Office, then we can click Microsoft PowerPoint. Second one is, shortcut key to save the presentation in PowerPoint. And the right answer is Control plus S. And the third one is, shortcut key to close PowerPoint. And the right answer is Alt plus F4. And the fourth one is, shortcut key to start slideshow from the first slide. And the shortcut key is F5 key. And the fifth question is, what is a file extension of presentation file in PowerPoint? And the right answer is .pptx. And the sixth one is, which term or word is used to open PowerPoint using run box? And the right answer is power, power, pnt. So now we will learn about short answer type question in lesson number 4. The first question is, what is PowerPoint? And the answer is, PowerPoint is a presentation graphic software. It is a part of MS Office. It allows us to create effective electronic slideshow. We can add animation effect, etc. to the presentation in PowerPoint to make it more effective. And the second question is, write a short note on presentation. And the answer is, presentation is the process of presenting a topic to the viewers in an interesting way. The purpose of the presentation is to make the content easily understandable using pictures, text, animation, etc. A presentation can have one or more slides. We can easily create presentation in the PowerPoint. And the third question is, what is a slide? And the answer is, a slide is a page of presentation. It is like a 35mm film-based slide. The slide can be considered as a workspace in PowerPoint where we place the content to create the presentation. A presentation can have one or more slides. And the fourth question is, write the main component of PowerPoint window. And the answer is, following are the main component of a PowerPoint window. The first one is title bar, second one is ribbons and tabs, third one is outline or slide tab, fourth one is slide pan, fifth one is notes pan, sixth one is status bar, and seventh one is view options. And the fifth question is, how will you play a presentation for the audience in PowerPoint? And the answer is, PowerPoint provides a variety of ways to play our presentation for viewers. Here are some key ways. The first one is, press the shortcut key F5 to start the presentation from the first slide. And the second one is, press the shortcut key Shift plus F5 to start the presentation from the current slide. And the sixth question is, write about slide pan and note pan in PowerPoint. And the answer is, following is the description of slide pan and notes pan. And the first one is slide pan. This pan shows the current slide in our presentation. The second one is notes pan. This pan is located at the bottom of the slide pan. This pan is used to type notes related to slide contents. So now we will learn about long answer type question. So our first question is, explain any three component of PowerPoint window. And the answer is, PowerPoint window has several components. Three main components are described below. The first one is slide pan. This pan shows the current slide in our presentation. Second one is notes pan. This pan is located at the bottom of the slide pan. This pan is used to type notes related to slide content. Third one is title bar. This is the topmost bar of the PowerPoint window. This bar displays the name of the software like Microsoft PowerPoint and the name of the currently opened file. And second question is, how will you create photo album presentation in PowerPoint? And the answer is, we can create photo album presentation in PowerPoint very easily. The steps for creating a photo album presentation are as follows. The first one is, click on the insert tab. Second one is, click on the photo album option in the images group and then click on the new photo album option. And third one is, the photo album dialog box will open. Select the images using the file or disk option. Fourth one is, set up various options for images in the album dialog box. Fifth one is, finally click on the create button in the album dialog box. And sixth one is, this will create a new photo album presentation. So now we learned about multiple choice question in lesson number 5, Teddy Advanced PowerPoint Part 1. So the first question is, a dash defines the design and placement of different elements on a slide. And the options are background style, placeholder, slide layout, and the last one is pattern. And the right answer is, a slide layout defines the design and placement of different elements on a slide. And second one is, a dash is a blend of two or more colors merging into each other. And the answer is theme, pattern, background style, and the last one is gradient. And the right answer is, a gradient is a blend of two or more colors merging into each other. And the third one is, dash is the default view where we create, edit, and design our slides. And the options are normal view, slideshow, slide sorter view, and the last one is reading view. And the right answer is, normal view is the default view where we create, edit, and design our slides. And the fourth one is, there are dash default slide background style available in PowerPoint 2010, and their options are 48, 4, 12, and the last one is 3. And the right answer is there are 12 default slide background style available in PowerPoint 2010. And the fifth one is the dash control allow us to zoom in for a closer look at slide contents. And the options are zoom, slide, normal view, and the last one is gradient. And the right answer is the zoom control allow us to zoom in for a closer look at slide contents. So now we learn about very short answer type questions. So the first question is, what is the shortcut key to insert a new slide? And the right answer is Control plus M. And the second one is, what is the shortcut key to create a new presentation? And the right answer is Control plus N. And the third question is, which tab is used to format text on the slide? And the right answer is Home tab. And the fourth one is, which PowerPoint view is used to deliver our presentation to an audience? And the right answer is slideshow view. The fifth one is, which bar contains the view button and zoom slider in PowerPoint? And the right answer is status bar. So now we will learn about short answer type question. So our first question is, write the steps to create a new presentation using file tab in PowerPoint. And the answer is following are the steps to create a new presentation file using the file tab. The first one is click on the file tab. Second one is click on the new option. Third one is click on blank presentation. And fourth one is click on the create button. And second question is, what are placeholder? And the answer is, the placeholder are the dotted line container that are shown on the slide layout. They can hold a variety of content such as title, table, chart, picture, clip art, etc. And the third question is, what are themes? And the answer is, a theme is a predefined set of colors, font, and visual effect. We use themes in our presentation to set a consistent and professional look of our slides. And the fourth question is, write the name of different view button available at the status bar of PowerPoint window. And the answer is, status bar has four view button with a zoom slider. And the first one is normal view, second one is slide sorter view, third one is reading view, and fourth one is slideshow view. The fifth question is, what is gradient fill? And the answer is, a gradient is a mixture of two or more colors that merge with each other. The gradient fill is an option which is used to apply the gradient as a slide background. This option appears in the format background dialog box. And the sixth question is, which options are available in the fill pane of the format background dialog box? And the answer is, the fill pane has the following options. The first one is solid fill, second one is gradient fill, third one is picture or texture fill, fourth one is pattern fill. So now we will learn about long answer type questions. So the first question is, explain briefly about the different method to change the appearance of slides. And the answer is, we can easily change the appearance of slide using the options available in the design tab of PowerPoint. The main method to change the appearance of a slide are as follows. The first one is themes. A theme is a predefined set of colors, font, and visual effect. We use theme to set a consistent and professional look of our slides. Second one is background style. The picture or design element that are placed behind the text, chart, etc. on the slide are called PowerPoint background. We can change this background of slide with the help of the background style option. And the second question is, what is slide layout? How will you change it in PowerPoint? And the answer is, slide layout defines the design and placement of different elements on a slide. We can also change the layout of the slide after inserting the slide into the presentation. The steps are as follows. The first one is select the slide whose layout we want to change. Second one is click on the layout drop down menu in the slide group of the home tab. And third one is click on the layout as per the requirement. And the third question is write about the slide view options in PowerPoint. And the answer is following is the description of PowerPoint slide view option. The first one is normal view. This is the default view where we create, edit, and design our slides. Second one is slide sorter view. This view displays presentation slides in thumbnail form. Third one is reading view. This view fills most of the computer screen with a preview of our presentation. And the fourth one is slideshow view. We use slideshow view to display our presentation to the audience. So now we will learn about multiple choice question in lesson number 6, that is advanced PowerPoint part 2. So the first question is, a dash is the visual and motion effect that occurs when we move from one slide to the next slide during a presentation. And the options are slide transition, animation, animation scheme, and the last one is slideshow. And the right answer is A. Slide transition is the visual and motion effect that occurs when we move from one slide to the next slide during a presentation. And second one is PowerPoint provides dash type of animations, and the options are 2, 3, 4, and the last one is 5. And the right answer is PowerPoint provides 4 types of animation. And the third one is presentation provides predefined collection of animation effect, which are also known as dash. And the options are slide transition, animation, animation scheme, and the last one is slideshow. And the right answer is PowerPoint provides predefined collection of animation effect, which are also known as animation scheme. And the fourth one is full form of PDF is dash, and the options are portable document, portable document form, and next one is portable data form, and the last one is portable document format. And the right answer is full form of PDF is portable document format. And the fifth one is, we can save our PowerPoint presentation as a PowerPoint show with dash extension, and the options are .ppsx, .ppt, .pptx, and the last one is .pdf. And the right answer is, we can save our PowerPoint presentation as a PowerPoint show with .ppsx extension. So now we will learn about fill in the blank. So the first one is, using dash tab we can apply transition effect, and the right answer is, using transition tab we can apply transition effect. And second one is, dash option allow us to increase or decrease the duration of time of the effect, and the answer is, duration option allow us to increase or decrease the duration or time of the effect. And the third one is, dash option is used to copy animation effect, and the right answer is, animation painter option is used to copy animation effect. And the fourth one is, to save a presentation file in other format we have to use dash option. And the right answer is, to save a presentation file in other format we have to use save as option. So now we will learn about short answer type questions. So the first question is, what is slide transition? And the answer is, slide transition are visual and motion effect. These effects are visible to us as we move from one slide to the next slide during the slideshow of the presentation. We use the transition tab to apply transition effect to the presentation. And the second question is, what is animation? And the answer is, animation are visual effect. These effects indicate movement on the object during the presentation. These slide object can be anything such as text, pictures, chart, shape, etc. We can use the animation tab to apply animation effect to the presentation. And the third one is, what are the animation schemes in PowerPoint? And the answer is, PowerPoint provides a collection of predefined animation effect. This collection of animation effect is called animation schemes. We can use the animation tab to implement animation scheme in the presentation. The fourth question is, how will you preview animations in PowerPoint? And the answer is, following are the steps to preview the animation effect. The first one is, click on the preview button of the animation tab. And second one is, animation effect will begin to play for the current slide. And the fifth question is, write the name of 4 type of animations available in PowerPoint. And the answer is, PowerPoint provide 4 types of animation. The first one is entrance, second one is emphasis, third one is exit, and the fourth one is motion path. So now we will learn about long answer type question in lesson number 6. So the first question is, what is animation? What are these types in PowerPoint? And the answer is, animation are visual effect. These effects indicate movement on the object during the presentation. These slide object can be anything such as text, pictures, chart, shapes, etc. We can use the animation tab to apply animation effect to the presentation. PowerPoint offers four types of animation. First one is entrance, second one is emphasis, third one is exit, and fourth one is motion path. And second question is, how will you save PowerPoint presentation in PDF format? And the answer is, following are the steps to save the presentation in PDF format. The first one is click on the file tab. Second one is click on save as option. Third one is set the name and location of the file to save it. Fourth one is select the PDF format from the save as type drop down list. And last one is now click on the save button to create the PDF file. And the third question is, how will you apply slide transition in PowerPoint? And the answer is, slide transition are visual and motion effect. These effects are visible to us as we move from one slide to the next slide during the slideshow of the presentation. Following steps can be used to apply transition effect to a presentation. The first one is click on the transition tab. Second one is select the desired transition effect from the transition to this slide group. Third one is set other options such as sound, duration, etc. And the fourth one is click on apply to all option to apply the same transition to all the slides. So now we will learn about multiple choice question in lesson number 7, that is generation of computer. So the first question is, second generation use the dash as their basic component, and their options are vacuum tube, VLSI, ULSI, and the last one is transistor. And the right answer is, second generation use the transistor as their basic component. And the second one is, the dash generation of computer used VLSI circuit, and their options are first, second, third, and the last one is fourth. And the right answer is, the fourth generation of computer use VLSI circuits. And the third one is, the third generation of computer use dash in place of transistor, and their options are integrated circuit, vacuum tube, ULSI, and the last one is VLSI. And the right answer is, the third generation of computer use integrated circuit in place of transistor. And the fourth one is, dash is an upcoming branch in computer science which interprets means and method of making computer think like human beings. And their options are robotics, ULSI, artificial intelligence, and the last one is integrated circuit. And the right answer is, artificial intelligence is an upcoming branch in computer science which interprets means and method of making computer think like human beings. And the fifth one is, ULSI technology is used in dash generation of computers, and their options are second, third, fourth, and the last one is fifth. And the right answer is, ULSI technology is used in fifth generation of computers. So now we will learn about write the full forms. The first one is ENIAC. ENIAC stands for Electronic Numerical Integrated and Computer. And second one is IBM. IBM stands for International Business Machine. Third one is IC. IC stands for Integrated Circuit. Fourth one is VLSI. VLSI stands for Very Large Scale Integration. Fifth one is ULSI. ULSI stands for Ultra Large Scale Integration. Sixth one is AI. AI stands for Artificial Intelligence. So now we will learn about short answer type question of lesson number 7. So the first question is, write the main feature of first generation computer. And the answer is, the main feature of first generation computer are, vacuum tubes were used as basic processing component. And second one is, machine and assembly language were used in these generations. Third one is, size of this computer is very large. Fourth one is, this computer produced a lot of heat. And fifth one is, this computer were very expensive and difficult to use. And the second question is, which technology was used for second generation of computers? And the answer is, following technologies were used in this generation of computer. The first one is, transistor were used as basic processing component. Second one is, the magnetic core was used as the primary memory. Third one is, magnetic tape and disk were used as secondary storage devices. And the third question is, what is IC? So IC stands for integrated circuit. A single IC contains several transistors, resistor, and capacitor. IC was invented by Jack Kilby. These circuits were used to make third generation computers. And the fourth question is, write about fourth generation of computers. And the answer is, the time interval of fourth generation computer was from 1975 to 1989. Computer of this generation used VLSI circuit. This circuit made it possible to build fourth generation microcomputers. So computer of this generation were very popular, small and reliable. And the fifth question is, what is AI? Write the area which are included in AI. And the answer is, AI stands for artificial intelligence. It is a new branch of computer science that enable computer to think and act like humans. AI includes some of the key areas. And the first one is robotics. Second one is game playing. Third one is expert system. Fourth one is systems for understanding natural languages. And the sixth question is, write the example of first generation of computers. And the answer are, some of the main component of first generation computers are as follows. The first one is ENIAC, second one is ADVAC, third one is ADZAC. So now we will learn about long answer type questions. So the first question is, what do you mean by generation of computers? How are they classified? And the answer is, in the technical terminology of computer, a generation means the change in computer technology. Till now, computer generation have been classified into total five generation, which are as follows. The first one is first generation computer from 1942 to 1945. Second one is second generation computer from 1955 to 1964. Third one is third generation of computer from 1964 to 1975. Fourth one is fourth generation computer from 1975 to 1989. And the fifth one is fifth generation computer from 1989 to till present. And second question is, explain fifth generation of computers. And the answer are, the time period of fifth generation computer is from 1989 to till date. Fifth generation computer use ultra large scale integration technology. These ULSI microprocessor chips contain tens of millions of electronic components. Computer of this generation works on the basis of parallel processing hardware and artificial intelligence software. All high level languages like C, C++, Java, .NET, etc. are used in the computer of this generation. So now we will learn about multiple choice question in lesson number 8, that is memory unit. The first question is, a group of dash bits is called byte, and their options are 8, 16, 32, and the last one is 64. And the right answer is, a group of 8 bits is called byte. And second one is, a bit or binary digit may be represented by logical dash and dash. And their options are 01, 00, 12, 11. And the right answer is, a bit or a binary digit may be represented by logical 0 and 1. And third one is, RAM stands for dash, and their options are read access memory, random access memory, all of these or none of these. And the right answer is, RAM stands for random access memory. The fourth one is, ROM stands for dash, and their options are read only memory, random only memory, read open memory, and the last one is none of these. And the right answer is, ROM stands for read only memory. And fifth one is, each track of a disk is subdivided into a small portion known as dash, and their options are sector, area, cell, and the last one is tape. And the right answer is, each track of a disk is subdivided into a small portion known as sectors. So now we will learn about write the full form in lesson number 8. And the first one is MB. MB stands for megabyte. Second one is GB. GB stands for gigabyte. Third one is SRAM. SRAM stands for static random access memory. Fourth one is PROM. PROM stands for programmable read only memory. Fifth one is IR. IR stands for instruction register. So now we will learn about short answer type question. So first question is, what is memory? And the answer is, the memory of a computer is like the human brain. This is the storage area of the computer in which data and instructions are stored, computer memory is divided into many smaller parts called cells. Each cell has a unique memory address. And second question is, write the name of different type of memory. And the answer is, memory can be classified into two main types. The first one is internal memory and the second one is external memory. The third question is, what is primary memory? And the answer is, primary memory is internal memory. This memory is also called main memory. The CPU has direct access to this memory. Computer cannot start without this memory. Primary memory can be classified into two main categories, that is DRAM and ROM. The CPU can read data from these memories very quickly. And the fourth question is, write the name of various types of ROM. And the answer is, ROM stands for read-only memory. So following are the names of the different types of ROM. The first one is MROM, which stands for mask ROM. Second one is PROM. PROM stands for programmable read-only memory. Third is EPROM. EPROM stands for erasable and programmable read-only memory. And fourth one is EEPROM, which stands for electrically erasable and programmable read-only memory. So now we will learn about long answer type question in lesson number 8. So the first question is, explain RAM and ROM. And the answer are, RAM and ROM are the type of primary memory. They are described as follows. Now the first one is RAM. RAM stands for random access memory. It is a volatile memory. It means data in this memory gets lost when the computer turned off. It stores the programs and data that the computer system is using during our work. We can read and write data in this memory. And second one is ROM. So ROM stands for read-only memory. It is a non-volatile memory. It means data stored in this memory does not lost when the computer turned off. It stores the instructions used to start the computer. The data in this memory can only be read but cannot be written into it. And the second question is, explain the external memory. And the answer are, external memory is also called secondary or auxiliary or permanent memory. This memory is slower than the main memory. This memory is used to store data and information permanently. The CPU cannot access this memory directly. The data stored in the secondary memory is first transferred to the main memory. Then the CPU can access it. Hard disk, CD-ROM, DVD, etc. are the example of this memory. And third question is, explain the characteristic of secondary memory. And the answer are, characteristics of secondary memory are as follows. The first one is, it can be a magnetic or optical type of memory. Second one is, data is permanently stored in this memory even when power is off. And third one is, these memory keep data safe. Fourth one is, the data storage capacity of this memory is quite high. Fifth one is, storing data in this memory is much cheaper than in primary memory. Sixth one is, the computer can start without secondary memory. Seventh one is, its speed is slower than primary memory. And the fourth question is, what are tracks and sectors? And the answer are, track and sectors are the component of the physical structure of a magnetic disk. The surface of any disk is divided into a number of invisible concentric circles. These circles are called track. These tracks are numbered consecutively starting from zero. The number of tracks may vary depending on the type and capacity of disk. So the track in the disk are divided into smaller section called sector. Each track can have 8 or more sector. Each sector has a storage capacity of 512 bytes. The fifth question is, what is cache memory? What are its advantages and disadvantages? And the answer are, cache memory is a very fast and semiconductor memory. This memory speeds up the CPU performance. It acts as a buffer between CPU and main memory. It stores data and instructions that are frequently used by CPU. The benefit of cache memory are, the first one is, cache memory is faster than main memory. Number two, the access time of cache memory is less than that of main memory. Third one is, a store program that can be run in a short interval of time. The disadvantages of cache memory are, the first one is, storage capacity of cache memory is very small. Second one is, it is very expensive. So student, if you like this video, don't forget to like and share this video, and also don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you will get all notification of more video like this. Thank you.